Hi YouTubers, my name is Lunacatz. And some of you YouTubers out there are probably parents and get to watch Disney Channel with your kids. Well, on the Disney Channel, they have a special segment called Pass the Plate. Well, I went to their website and come to find out, you can see all the recipes that are on the TV, but you can't add any of your own. So, I figured I would do a YouTube segment called Pass the Plate as well. But here, you will actually be able to share your family recipes with everybody else. Just repost a video blog back to this with your recipes, so that way everybody else can see what you can make. On today's segment, my challenge to you is give me your best bread recipe. Now, off to my left here, you're going to see the recipe that I have up, which is called the Boulder Sandwich, which is made with bagels. This recipe wasn't handed down in my family. It was actually given to me by my really good friend, Grady, who used to own a diner, but ended up going into a rock and roll band instead. And from what I understand, he's doing a really good job. Go Grady! Anywho, let's go on and make that food. Okay, to start things off, I'm making mine inside of my oven, so you'll need a cookie sheet. And if you do this in the microwave, make sure you're doing it on a microwave safe plate. And for the first step, you're going to want to take your cream cheese. Now a lot of people go, ew, cream cheese, with how I'm making it. Surprisingly, it tastes really good. I was ew at first when Grady had first told me about it, and you know, don't knock it till you try it. At least that's what my mom always told me. Don't knock it till you try it, Luna. So, yeah. So make sure that you get a nice, even coat of cream cheese on both sides. Now, in Grady's recipe, he had put pesto, and pesto is sold. You can buy it at the stores. It's a little green mixture of oregano and parsley and olive oil mixed together, but I sometimes just leave it off because the pesto kind of costs a lot of money. So if you're trying to do this cheaply, do it without the pesto. Get cream cheese with it already mixed in, like a garlic and herb, like that's what I'm using right now. I'm using a garlic and herb spread, and I'm not telling you what brand it is because I don't want to advertise any special company. So that's the first step. Then you put your pesto on. Now, depending on your taste, we'll go with what type of vegetables you put on. Me, I love bell peppers and onions, so I'll put some of those on here. Now, this is really cool. This is an actual already cut onion bell pepper mix, and you can get those in your produce section at the store. It's really nice. If you figure in the cost of bell pepper, the red, the green, and the onion bell peppers, once you get all the costs together, it'll still cost the exact same amount as getting it already pre-done. And it also saves you on tear work with the onions. Because tell me, ladies, how many of you love cooking and cutting up onions? Because trust me, I don't. I'm sure there's some men out there that don't like to do it either. So there's that there. And then we have our mushroom. Speaking of one of my little angels. Okay, she's alright. She's okay. She's just fighting with her brothers. Siblings, gotta love them. But I've got the mushrooms going on next. And then put your meat on. Now the meat is up to you. You don't have to have it if you're a vegetarian. So I know that some people out there are vegetarians and don't like to use meat. But if you are a meat lover, choose your favorite meat. I'm using ham today. Normally I choose turkey because it's a little bit healthier than ham. So I've been told, but I could be wrong. There's a nutritionist out there. I'm sure they'll post something in the comment section going, oh no, ham's, you know, more healthier. But hey, it's food. And food is what we're here for, right? Think that's enough? I think so. Yeah, we'll add a little more. There we go. And while you're cooking all this stuff, make sure that you're preheating your oven to at least 350. And if you want to add more types of meats, you can. You don't have to stick with just one. I mean, with the Boulder sandwich, it's your own choice. So, yeah. It's your own choice on how you want to go about it. And you can put as many sorts of cheeses on top. You want to top off with the cheese, though, because what the cheese does is it binds it all together. Now, I'm going to go ahead and use two slices, because when it melts, it's going to melt really good. Okay, so we have all that there. Voila. Now we'll put it in the oven. Okay, now we're going to go ahead and put it inside of our 350 degree oven. So let's go ahead and put this delicious thing in. Look at that. This is going to be great. Use a pot holder at all times. If you're making this with your kids, please put it in the oven for them. That way we're not having any 911 phone calls. Okay. And then what we're going to do is we're going to cook it on our kitchen timer here. Start off with 5 minutes. Actually, no. I'm sorry. Take that back. Okay, we're going to do it for 10 minutes. And let it do its thing. So I will check back
okay. In 10 minutes.
5 minutes has gone by. So let's go ahead and take a look here in the oven at how it's doing. And from the looks of it, it's actually done. If it looks like this when you check it, it is done. Because that's how you want it to look, okay? So, and this here, ladies and gentlemen, is our Boulders.